Always good to see you safe. So, what do you need? Ah, you defeated Godric and claimed yourself a great rune. Looks like we both got what we wanted out of Stormvale, didn't we? Well done, friend. Something to mark the occasion. Go on, take it. As you might have guessed, I still can't move. My fighting days are behind me. No need to be polite. I've no use for it anymore. The misshapen corpse under Stormvale. That is a sacred relic of the Black Knives plot, as that famed night of assassination is known. It happened during the golden age of the Erdtree, long before the shattering of the Elden Ring. Someone stole a fragment of the Rune of Death from Malaketh, the Black Blade, and on a bitter night, murdered Godwin the Golden. That was the first recorded death of a demigod in all history, and it became the catalyst. Soon, the Elden Ring was smashed, and thus sprang forth the war known as the Shattering. I once wished to become a scholar, you see. I've spent many an hour scouring the archives for knowledge of that fateful plot. The world has grown crooked, and if you intend to put it to rights, you'd better understand what happened to make it this way. And that thing is to blame for the shape I'm in now. I urge the utmost caution. Don't disturb the corpse more than necessary. Ah, so you've met Dee. Dee is an old friend. We found ourselves journeying together for a time, bound by our exploration of death. But our paths have since diverged, never again to cross. Though that's hardly an uncommon fate for two friends. Dee was telling me that he discovered the mark of the centipede. The centipede is an ancient symbol of the curse mark. As long as whoever finds and uses it is not nefarious by nature, then we may be able to form an alliance. If only I could speak to them in person, and if they were like you, all the better.
Took you for dead. No matter, it's all the same. Lay out your arms, then.
Greetings. Are you here for spirit tuning? I can hear it from across the wing, past the round table. The howling and wailing of spirits in fear of the curse. I can even hear the repulsive, twisted malice in itself. You should keep your distance. I know you're strong, but please.
You have returned. What is it? Now, Goof. You have returned. What is it? Now go forth. Let the words of the fingers guide you.
Ah, there you are. You claimed a great rune and had your audience with the two fingers at the round table hole. What was your impression? You don't say. Well, what a relief that must be. You may go then. My work here is done. May the wisdom... Oh? Aha! Your intuition serves you well. My doubts had been piling up, you see. The words of the two fingers cannot be trusted. Truly, naught but rambling, senile delusions. I believe that when the Elden Ring was shattered, the two fingers were corrupted. Their guidance skewed. Even worse, the fingers harbor no love for our kind. That's the part that irks the most. Oh, I have a gift for you, something fit only for the wise. Means for circumventing the draw of the two fingers. Give it a try, won't you? And if it please you, may we meet again. I've high hopes for you, my lambkin. Be sure to try that. There's no tarnished, was spurned by grace, forsaken by the two fingers. And now they ask you to mend their crumbling world? Your loyalties are misplaced with them.
you again. I don't want any trouble. On your way then. Dirty scoundrel. There's something off about this from the start.
It's you. Always a pleasure.
Lambkin. So pleased you're here. I'm glad that you're enjoying my gift. I knew it from the very start. You have a taste for noble blood. I wish to anoint you a proper inductee. A knight to serve Luminary Moog, the Lord of Blood, and establish a new dynasty. Luminary Moog has strength, vision, and of course, love. So, what do you say, my lambkin? Yes. Who would have it any other way? Now, take this for your final trial. Soak the cloth with a maiden's blood. Normally, this ritual would involve killing one's own maiden and recanting the wisdom of the two fingers. But since you are maidenless, the blood of anyone's maiden will do. The cloth, the blood of anyone's maiden will...